So we're going to kind of switch gears here now. We're going to talk about function notation. Function notation. So here's the deal. Up until now, you've had stuff like this. Y equals X plus 3. And I'd ask a question, something like, you know, what is Y when X equals 3? Not 3. Let's do something different. Let me try this again. I want to use this example. There. Y equals X squared plus 1. Say, what is Y when X equals 3? You say, I can do that. Everywhere I see an X, I'm going to plug in a 3. And I'm going to solve. The answer is 10. Yay! Yeah. So this is what you're used to. Here's the other way. This is going to be called function notation. I can't spell. Function notation. Function notation is the exact same thing. It means the exact same thing, but we write it as f of x is x squared plus 1. So the way we say this is f of x is x squared plus 1. F of x. So that's our f of x. Now, the way I would ask the question is I would say, what is f of 3? Okay. So this question here and this question here are the exact same question. They're just phrased differently. So if I want to know what is f of 3, what I'm really saying is, what is the output when x equals 3? And the way to do that is I recognize, okay, everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 3. If I want to know f of 3, here inside the parentheses was x, but now inside the parentheses is 3. So that must mean everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 3. Where I put an x, I'm going to put a 3. That 9 plus 1 is 10. I get the same answer. It's just a different way of asking the same question. Okay. So let's do some practice. So I'm going to stick with this f of x is x squared plus 1. They'll give you the function. They'll tell it to you off the top. And let's say I want to find f of 4. So I'm going to color that in red. Get it erased. So if I want to find f of 4, okay. So say, all right, well, everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 4. So here, instead of x squared, I'm going to put 4 squared. And to be perfectly honest, that's about as straightforward of a problem as you can get. Say, well, what is f of 0? So everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 0. Like that. All right, what if I ask for f of negative 1? The parentheses are going to get you, so make sure you do your parentheses. All right, well, everywhere I have a negative 1, or an x, everywhere I have an x, I'm going to put a negative 1. Got it? You just think you do. All right? So here's what else we can do. This is fun. Tacking key. I'm sorry. What if I say, what is f of x plus 3? All right? So pause it. You know, pause the video. See if you can figure this out. See if you can make it work. We're going to follow the same basic strategy, which is everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put an x plus 3.
Say that's good.
So instead of x squared, it's going to be x plus 3 squared. It's a direct substitution. Here, everywhere I saw x, I put a 4. Everywhere I saw an x, I put a 0. Everywhere I saw an x, I put a negative 1. Everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put an x plus 3. And the rest of the function follows. And then all I do is I simplify from there. First, outer, inner, last, plus 1. and you're golden. Fun?
Yeah.
All right. Try f of negative x. Again, nothing to get too concerned about. Everywhere you see an x in the original function, put a negative x. Negative x squared is x squared plus 1. You actually get the same thing back. Not a problem, but it's kind of fun. Actually, before I get too excited, I want to go back to this for a second. All right, so take a look at this. We have f of x, x squared plus 1 still. Now, what if I said if f of x is equal to, 26, what is x? Okay, so for some reason, these problems just completely baffle the mind. But it's really not that strange, actually. If f of x is 26, so we're going to substitute. So if f of x is 26, so what f of x is, don't really know what to do, so we turn a problem we don't know how to do into something that we do. So we're going to replace, instead of writing f of x, we're going to replace it with this. Because that's what f of x is, right? These are the same thing. So we should be able to replace this with this. So f of x is x squared plus 1. If that is 26, now can you solve for x? Hopefully. Get it by itself, the whole isolate and destroy thing. Again, the whole point is we're trying to turn a problem that we don't know how to solve into something that we do. Square root of both sides, plus or minus out front. And now you've got x equals plus or minus 5. So if f of x is 26, x could be 5 or negative 5. And that's how that works.